Hello, this is a continued session of the 10th chapter, that is Haloalkanes and Haloarenes. The topics we will be studying in this session would be the chemical reactions, the reactions of haloalkanes, that is substitution reaction, elimination reaction and reaction with metals. In the next session we will be studying the reaction of haloarenes. So these are the chemical reactions what they perform. So the chemical reactions, the reactions of haloalkane may be divided into the following categories, that is nucleophilic substitution, elimination reaction and reaction with metals. Now nucleophilic substitution reaction, in this type of reaction a nucleophile reacts with haloalkane. We have studied about a nucleophile, that is a nucleus loving or electron donating group, reacts with haloalkane, the substrate having a partial positive charge on the carbon atom bonded to halogen. A substitution reaction takes place and halogen atom called leaving group departs as halide ion. Since the substitution reaction is initiated by a nucleophile, it is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now nucleophilic substitution of alkyl halides Rx, when a nucleophile Nu- reacts with Rx, RNU bond is being formed and X minus is being substituted. Now what happens, a nucleophile, that is nucleus loving or electron donating group, it substitutes the halide ion on the haloalkane, on the alkyl group. Now what happens, it comes from a side, from other the other side of the halide group, and it gets attached to it. Now the mechanism is shown in the next slide. These are the reagents and some of the nucleophiles, their substitution and the main products. When sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, they have OH minus as their nucleophile, the minus charges on O. H2O, the nucleophile is H2O. NOR dash, if a compound is NOR dash, then the nucleophile will be R dash O minus. All the negative or the anionic part of the sodium and potassium groups is can act as a nucleophile. For example, here we can see these first three, sodium iodide, then I minus, ammonia as a nucleophile, they act as a nucleophile. R dash NH2, KCN, we have C triple bond N. We have two sites from where the nucleophile can attack based on the charge distribution and the alkyl group it is being reacted to. AGCN, we have again N has load pairs. KNO2, we have ONO bonds where the NO bond is coordinate and a bond can be formed. Similarly, AgNO2, the lone pairs on oxygen. R dash C double bond Ag, again this is a anionic part. Li AlH4, which has nucleophile H. Now this is a very important reagent, Li AlH4. It gives the nucleophile H and is used for substituting the hydrogen in place of the halide to make the alkyl halide and alkyl chain. So R dash M plus, is it has R dash minus. Now the substitution, what happens, the first two cases ROH being formed, the main product is alcohol. RO R dash is being formed in case of NaOR dash, it is a form of ether. RI is being formed in case of NaI, it is known as alkyl iodide. R NH2 primary amine, R NH R dash is secondary amine, R NH R N R dash R double dash is tertiary amine. Now these are the these are also used for the preparing the alkyl halide or the for primary, secondary and tertiary amine from alkyl halides. Now RCN, that is nitrile or cyanide, R NC or isocyanide, used to form isonitrile compounds. RON double bond O alkyl nitrate, RNO2 nitroalkane, R dash C double bond OR OR, that is ester, or RH to form hydrocarbons. Now LiLH4 is used to form RH, that are hydrocarbons. RR dash is alkane. Groups like cyanides and nitrides possesses two nucleophilic centers and are called amidian nucleophiles, as we have seen. In case of CN, we have C minus as the nucleophile, or N lone pair as a nucleophile. Actually, cyanide group is a hybrid of two contributing structures and therefore can act as a nucleophile in two different ways, that is in the following ways. That is, linking through carbon atom, resulting in alkyl cyanides, and through nitrogen atom, leading to isocyanides. Similarly, the nitrite ion also represents an ambidient nucleophile with two different points of linkage, O and O. The linkage through oxygen results in alkyl nitrites, while through oxygen atom it leads to nitroalkanes. Now the mechanism. This reaction has been found to proceed by two different mechanisms which are described below. The substitution nucleophilic bimolecular, or we can say bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, or SN2 reaction. The reaction between CH3Cl and hydroxide ion to yield methanol and chloride ion follows a second order kinetics. That is, the rate depends upon the concentration of both the reactants. Now that is the reason why it is also known as SN2 mechanism. When OH minus, it gets attached to the alkyl group containing the halide, in this case it is chlorine. So a substrate is being formed. Now this the molecule, the interstitial molecule, it is formed for a very less time, and then we get the following configuration, and Cl minus gets out. Now the geometry is being opposed. What we had earlier and what we have now, it is totally different. It depicts a bimolecular nucleophilic displacement reaction, SN2 reaction. The incoming nucleophilic interacts with alkyl halide, causing the carbon halide bond to break while forming a new carbon OH bond. These two processes take place simultaneously in a single step and no intermediate is formed. As the reaction progresses and the bond between the nucleophile and the carbon atom starts forming, the bond between carbon atom and leaving group weakens. As this happens, the configuration of carbon atom under attack inverts in much the same way as an umbrella is turned inside out when caught in a strong wind. So it gets inside out while the leaving group is pushed away. This process is called an inversion of configuration, since the whole configuration is being inverse because of the attack of a nucleophile. In the transition state, the carbon atom is simultaneously bonded to incoming nucleophile and outgoing leaving group, and such structures are unstable and cannot be isolated. This is because the carbon atom in the transition state is simultaneously bonded to 5 atoms and therefore is unstable. Since the reaction requires the approach of the nucleophile to the carbon bearing the leaving group, the presence of bulky substituents on or near carbon have a dramatic inhibiting effect. Of the simple alkyl halides, methyl halides react most rapidly in SN2 reaction. Now, the more the bulkier groups, since CH3Cl, we had H atoms around the carbon. If we had R, that is another alkyl groups around the atom which is going under display substitution, then SN2 would be a bit difficult for it. Tertiary halides are the least reactive because bulky groups hinder the approaching nucleophiles. Thus, the order of reactivity of the halides is: primary halides readily give SN2 reaction, secondary halide gives more readily than tertiary halide. Since the group that hinders the incoming nucleophile, it is more in tertiary halide. So that is why primary halides give the best, or the most readily reacted with by SN2 nucleophilic substitution. Now this is the pictorial view of 1 degree methyl, 0 degree, 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree. The more the are the more the groups attached to bulky groups attached to the carbon getting the attack by the nucleophile, the difficult is the situation. Now, nucleophilic substitution reaction or unimolecular substitution reaction or SN1 reaction. SN1 reactions are generally carried out in polar protic solvents, that is water, alcohol, acetic acid, etc. Now, the reaction between tertiary butyl bromide and hydroxide ion yields a tertiary butyl alcohol and follows the first order kinetics, that is the rate of the reaction, depend upon the concentration of only one reactant only, which is tertiary butyl bromide. So, the more amount of the butyl bromide is present, the more forward reaction we get. And thus, this reaction is known as unimolecular substitution reaction or SN1 reaction. Now, what happens when 2-bromo-2-methylpropane, it gets attacked by OH minus nucleophile? What happens is the bromine ion, it gets out, and OH minus ion, it gets attached to the carbon, having the halide bond. Now, we saw in the SN2 reaction that it is very difficult for an incoming nucleophile to attack a 3-degree carbon and displace the halide attached to it. But for the OH minus in SN1 reaction, it is very easy to displace bromine from the given compound. Now, it occurs in two steps. The mechanism is being discussed now. In step 1, the polarized carbon-bromine bond undergoes slow cleavage to produce a carbocation and a bromide ion. The carbocation thus formed is then attacked by a nucleophile in step 2 to complete the substitution reaction. Now, what happens? It is in equilibrium, this is the reaction. When bromine gets out from the 2-bromo-2-methylpropane, when it gets out, then we have the following geometry. And since it is a 3-degree carbocation, which is very much stable due to the plus I effect of the CH3 groups attached, or a plus isomeric effect, the positive charge on the central carbon atom, it gets delocalized, and it is very much stable. Then the OH minus ion, it reacts with the compound and forms CH3COH. Step 1 is the slowest and reversible. It involves carbon and bromine bond breaking, for which the energy is obtained through solvation of halide ion with the proton of protic solvent. Since the rate of reaction depends upon the slowest step, the rate of reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide and not on the concentration of hydroxide ion. Further, greater the stability of carbocation, greater will be its ease of formation from alkyl halide, and faster will be the rate of the reaction. In case of alkyl halides, 3-degree alkyl halides undergo SN1 reaction very fast because of the stability of 3-degree carbocations. We can sum up the order of reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN1 and SN2 reaction as follows. For SN2 reaction, tertiary halide, secondary halide, primary halide, and then CH3X. That is for SN2 reaction. This is how it progresses and how fast it can act. But for SN1 reaction, tertiary halide gives the fastest reaction among all these compounds. Now, for the same reason, allylic and benzylic show high reactivity towards the SN1 reaction. Since the carbocation formed by allylic and benzylic position is very much stable due to the effect of resonance, therefore, the charge gets delocalized of the carbocation and it can be easily attacked by a nucleophile. For a given alkyl group, the reactivity of halide RX follows the same order in both the mechanism. That is, RI is readily displaced by RBR, RCL and RF. That is, RF has the least reactivity. Now, stereochemical aspects of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now, the name stereochemical, that is related to light. For SN2 reaction, proceeds with complete stereochemical inversion, while SN1 reaction proceeds with racemization. In order to understand this concept, we need to learn some basic stereochemical principles and notations, that is optical activity, chirality, retention, inversion, and racemization, etc. Now, PPL, or plain polarized light, and optical activity. Now, certain compounds rotate the PPL products by passing ordinary light through Nicol prism. PPL is being obtained. When it passes through their solution, such compounds are called optically active compounds. The angle by which the plane polarized light is rotated is measured by an instrument called polarimeter. If the compound rotates the plane polarized light to right, that is clockwise direction, it is called dextrorotatory, or the D-form, and it is indicated by the placing a positive sign before the degree of rotation. If the light is rotated towards the left or anti-clockwise direction, the compound is said to be levorotatory, or I-form or L-form, and a negative sign is placed before the degree of a rotation. Such plus and minus isomers of a compound are called optical isomers, and the phenomena is termed as optical isomerism. So this is a definition of optical isomerism. Now next is molecular asymmetry, chirality, and enantiomers. The observation of Louis Pasteur, the one who gave Pasteur effect, that crystals of certain compounds exist in the form of mirror images, laid the foundation of modern stereochemistry. He demonstrated that aqueous solution of both types of crystals showed optical rotation equal in magnitude for solution of equal concentration but opposite in direction. He believed that this difference in the spatial arrangement of four groups, valencies around a central atom, carbon is tetrahedral, and if all the substituents attached to the carbon are different, such a carbon is called a symmetric carbon or stereocenter. The resulting molecule would lack symmetry and is referred to as asymmetric molecule. The asymmetry of the molecule is responsible for the optical activity in such organic compounds. Now let us consider the molecule propane 2-ol and butane 2-ol and their mirror images. This is propane 2-ol and these are the mirror images. If we rotate the mirror image by 180 degree, we get the same A back. C is obtained by rotating B by 180 degree. C is superimposable on its mirror image A. That is, C can fit exactly right into the places where A is. As you can see very clearly, propane 2-ol does not contain an asymmetric carbon. As for all the four groups attached to the tetrahedral carbon are not different. Thus, it is an achiral molecule. So, for a chiral molecule, all the groups attached should be different. Butane 2-ol has four different groups attached to the tetrahedral carbon and is expected is chiral. Some common examples of chiral compounds are 2-chlorobutane, 2-dihydroxypropanol, bromochloroiodomethane, 2-bromopepionic acid, etc. The stereoisomers related to each other as non-superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. Now, enantiomers are the two non-superimposable mirror images of a stereoisomer. Enantiomer possesses identical physical properties, namely melting point, boiling point, refracting index, etc. They only differ with respect of the rotation of plane polarized light. If one of the enantiomer is dextrorotatory, the other will be levorotatory. A mixture containing two enantiomer in equal proportion will have zero optical rotation, as the rotation due to one isomer will be cancelled by the other. Such a mixture is known as a racemic mixture or racemic modification. A racemic mixture is represented by prefixing DL or plus minus before the name. For example, plus minus butane 2-ol will represent the racemic mixture of butane 2-ol, that it has both plus levorotatory and dextrorotatory isomers. The process of conversion of enantiomer into a racemic mixture is known as racemization. Now this is another definition for racemization, is the formation of racemic mixture. Now retention. Retention of configuration is the preservativity of integrity of spatial arrangement of the bonds to an asymmetrical center during a chemical reaction or transformation. It is also the configurational correlation when a chemical species XCABC is converted into a chemical species YCABC having the same relative configuration. Now this is the bond, this is a chiral carbon having all four groups different. Now X being displaced by Y. Now it has the same geometry, so it is said to be retained. So retention. Now inversion, retention and racemization. There are only three outcomes for a reaction that an asymmetric carbon atom consider the replacement of group X and Y in the following reaction. Like this. If A is the only compound obtained, the process is called retention of configuration. If B is the only compound obtained, the process is called inversion of configuration. If a 50-50 of both is obtained, then it is called a racemic mixture. This is A, this is B. If both are equal in number, A plus B, then it is a racemic mixture. If A is obtained, there is a retention. And if B is obtained, there is an inversion. Now, when a haloalkane with beta hydrogen atom is heated with alcoholic solution of potassium hydroxide, this is the elimination reaction. There is elimination of hydrogen atom of beta carbon and a halogen from alpha atom. As a result, an alkene is formed. Since beta hydrogen atom is involved in elimination, it is formed called as beta elimination reaction. Now, what happens? The H bond, it gets from here to here, and C gives its pair to X. Now this is being formed, this intermediate is being formed, a double bond gets into the given compound, BH gets out and X minus gets out in the solution. If there is possibility of formation of more than one alkene due to availability of more than one beta hydrogen atoms, usually one alkene is formed as the major. These form part of a pattern process observed by Russian chemist Alexander Zaitsev, also pronounced, who in 1875 formulated a rule which can be summarized as, in dehydrohalogenation reaction, the preferred product is that alkene which has greater number of alkyl groups attached to the doubly bond carbon atoms to give the minus I effect and or to give the plus I effect and nullify the charge on the atom. Thus, 2-bromopentane gives pentoene as the major product. Since the beta, there are 2 beta hydrogens, but this beta hydrogen will be removed because the carbon ion formed here would be 2 degree, whereas here it is 1 degree. Now the reaction with metals. Most of the organic chlorides, bromides and iodides react with certain metals to give compounds containing carbon metal bonds. Such compounds are known as organometallic compounds. An important class of organometallic compounds discovered by Victor Grignard in 1900 is alkyl magnesium halide. Now this is known as Grignard reagents, or MGX. These reagents are obtained by the reaction of haloalkanes with magnesium metal in dry ether. Now, we take the haloalkane or the alkyl halide with magnesium in dry ether, and if they react, form the following intermediate. In the Grignard reagent, the carbon magnesium bond is covalent but highly polar. With carbon pulling electrons from electropositive magnesium, the magnesium halogen bond is essentially ionic. Grignard reagents are highly reactive and react with any source of proton to give hydrocarbons. Even water alcohols, amines are sufficiently acidic to convert them to corresponding hydrocarbons. It is therefore necessary to avoid even traces of moisture from the Grignard reagent. On the other hand, this could be considered as one of the methods for converting halides to hydrocarbons. Now we have Wood's reaction. Alkyl halides react with sodium in dry ether to give hydrocarbons containing double the number of carbon atoms present in the halide. This reaction is known as Wood's reaction. So Wood's reaction and the Grignard reagent, they are only two reactions of metals with the alkyl halides. Grignard reagents is used to double the amount of hydrocarbons in a given hydrocarbon compound, and is known as Wood's reaction when sodium is being reacted. Grignard reagents is used to give this compound, this intermediate. So these are the reaction with metals and various reaction of only haloalkanes. In the next session, we'll be discussing about the chemical reaction of haloarenes. So for more information, log in into Webcoach, and you can also refer class 12th NCERT textbook for further information. Thank you.